There is still no date set for the federal election, but the Prime Minister has made it clear today it will be families, he believes, is the key to winning it. Tomorrow's federal budget will be all about easing the cost of living. That started today with moves to help more first home buyers into a property. Here's our political editor, Peter Van Onselen.
The Prime Minister needs tomorrow night's budget to see a lift in his polling numbers, which have been a headache for him all year. A rearguard action during the election campaign only possible if Josh Frydenberg's budget lands tomorrow night.
This budget is about addressing the cost of living pressures being faced by Australian families.
This Prime Minister only holds a hose if it's spraying borrowed money on the eve of an election.
Adjusting the fuel excise to lower petrol prices is expected to be among a suite of measures announced in tomorrow night's budget, offering quick relief to families and businesses if it's passed on at the Bowser.
No government can fix it. You can mitigate it, you can mollify it.
Just 2 minutes to the election being called, and now they discover cost of living is an issue.
The federal government has confirmed the home guarantee scheme will double to 50,000 places.
In essence, a scheme which allows first home buyers to purchase a home with a deposit of as little as 5%.
$17.9 billion will be put towards road, rail and runway infrastructure projects right around the country. With so much spending afoot, how does the Coalition plan to address the debt and deficit disaster it first flagged a decade ago?
You want to know how to balance a budget? You get people into jobs.
Really? Because unemployment is at the lowest level it's been since 2008, yet government debt is ticking up towards $1 trillion, with four more years of deficits likely to again be forecast in tomorrow's budget.
Anthony Albanese was in government for 6 years, wasn't part of one.
That is true. So let's add up how many budgets the PM's been involved with. Here's Scott Morrison doing the maths the other day.
The budgets that I've been involved in, and this will be my eighth. I did three budgets as a treasurer, and this will be my fourth as a prime minister.
With numerical skills like that, no wonder it's wall-to-wall deficits as far as the eyes can see.
Well, PVO joins us now from Canberra. Pete, even more than usually, there's a lot riding on this budget for the Prime Minister.
No doubt about that, Hugh. It's without doubt the most important budget this year, we know that. But because it's an election year, it's doubly important politically speaking for the Prime Minister. Now, from most Australians' perspectives, it's all about cost of living pressures and what can be done to alleviate those. With interest rates likely to head north, with inflation on the rise, these are what Australians are going to be looking at. But for the government's perspective, it's all about the politics. They need some sort of bounce ahead of the election campaign in the next couple of weeks being called. They got that 3 years ago and it ended up delivering them an unexpected victory. They need it again, but it's a lot harder this time. People bought the line that 3 years ago they were going to bring the budget back into the black. This time, it's wall-to-wall deficits. It's a much, much harder sell. We'll see how they go tomorrow night.
Absolutely. We'll be looking at it closely, PVO. Thank you.